Hi dear children, welcome to our English class. Today we are going to learn lesson 3, how the kangaroo got its legs. Let us start to solve this riddle. It's a 5-letter word. You keep your pen, pencils and erasers in it. It's a small bag. A pelican also has it. What is it? It is a pouch. P-O-U-C-H, pouch. Most of the kangaroos live on the continent of Australia. You see the picture. Here the kangaroo's front legs and back legs are not same. Front legs are shorter than the back legs, right? Today, let us learn how kangaroo got its different legs or how its front legs became shorter than the back legs. We can read, long ago, the kangaroo did not like this picture. He was a small woolly animal. He had 4 short legs and looked more like a rabbit. Kangaroo wanted to be different from all the other animals and be popular. So, he went to the little god, Voi, and said, make me different from all the other animals. But, the little god shouted at him and said to go away. Kangaroo went to the middle god, Ving, and said, make me different from all the other animals. Make me popular. But the middle god stood and without smile, said to him to go away. Lastly, he went to great god named Wang and asked him to make the kangaroo different from all the other animals. The great god Wang agreed to make him different from all other animals. And he called his dog named Dingo. Asked him to make kangaroo popular and different from other animals. Then Dingo started to running after the kangaroo. Dingo chased the kangaroo through the desert mountains. He ran till his front legs ached or pained. Still the kangaroo continued running. At last, his back legs also started paining. At last, they reached on a bridge. The kangaroo did not know how to cross the river. So, he stood on his legs and he began to hop. Hop means to jump high and lean. He hopped and hopped and hopped. Just like a kangaroo does now. Lord kangaroo. Therefore, he hopped faster and faster. Then, he folded his front legs which became shorter. Later, he hopped his back legs which became longer and stronger. Also, his tail became longer. Now, he is no longer look like a rabbit. The great god Wang had kept his promise. The kangaroo was now different from all the other animals. Dear children, read the chapter well. Now, we are going to learn about synonyms. What is synonyms? A word that has the same meaning as another word is called a synonym. Or, synonyms are the words that mean the same or almost the same. The synonyms of happy is pleased, cheerful, delighted, overjoyed, and joyful. Let us learn grammar. Now we are going to learn subject and predicate. A sentence has two parts. The first part of the sentence is called a subject. It tells us who or what is being talked about. See the example. The kangaroo hopped faster and faster. Here, the kangaroo, this is the first part, it is known as subject part. The second part of the sentence is called the predicate. It tells more about the subject, tells what the subject does or about the subject. See the example. The kangaroo hopped faster and faster. Here, hopped faster and faster. This is the second part. It's known as predicate part. See the sentence once again. The kangaroo hopped faster and faster. Here, the kangaroo, this is the first part or subject part. Hopped faster and faster, this is the second part or predicate part. Circle the subjects and underline the predicates. See the question. First one is, home cooked food is good for health. Here, home cooked food, this is the subject part. Is good for health, this is the predicates. Next example, Maria is traveling to Shillong. Here, Maria is subject part, is traveling to Shillong, predicate part. Next, the snail is crawling under the plant. Here, the snail is subject part, is crawling under the plant, this is the predicate. Verb agreement. When a subject takes a correct verb, we call it subject verb agreement. When a subject is singular, it takes a singular verb such as am, has, is, was, etc. Example, I am going to the market. Raju has a pen. Regu has a garden. Are singular subject and take singular verb. Next, when a subject is plural, it takes a plural verb such as are, where, have, etc. Example, we are going home. They are speaking to their father. They were running after the horse. Here, we, they are plural subject. So, it takes plural verb. Fill in the blanks with the correct verbs from the bracket. First of all, question is, those people dash very good at English. In this sentence, the subject those people is plural. So, it takes plural verb are. Next question. This box bears six sides. In this sentence, the subject this box is singular. So, it is a singular verb has. Next one. Her work dash neat. Here, the subject her work is singular. So, it takes singular verb is. Dingo chased the kangaroo through the desert, mountains and swamps.